all the bombshell.
Let me drop it. Let me
drop all the bombshell.
Can I go ahead?
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah.
Okay. The bombshell. So let me drop. Let me drop this bombshell here. First of all, we all know what Nigeria is and what Nigeria was and what Nigeria has become. Why do we want disintegration of Nigeria? First of all, I want disintegration of Nigeria, and I want freedom of Biafra. Now, in doing this, there may be possibility for a second option. And not until we have the room for that second option, which could be dividing Nigeria into two, the North and the South. And within the South, there may be another possibility to have total for each region of the southern part of Nigeria to be independent. Just like every well-to-do economy are doing all over the world, from Dubai to member state of the European Union to America, through federalism. So the second option is this, or the second reason for wanting Biafra is this. We cannot continue to be part of a country that sponsors terrorism. We don't want to be part of a country that have five different terrorist groups. We don't want to be paying for or paying the price of crime we did not commit. We don't want to be, and as I'm mentioning this, please, Mr. Moderator, I need a little bit time, you know, because this is very, very important.
Yeah, go ahead.
We don't want to be part of a country that whenever the one section of the country, which is the North, commit crime, we will be the one to pay the price. Now, I want to give you example of the price we are paying so far. We are paying the price of Nigeria becoming number three terrorist country in the world. We pay that price by Nigeria or Nigerians unable to travel to migrate to the United States of America. We are paying that price. The terrorism did not emanate from us, the southern part of Nigeria. We pay the price. We are paying the price of the fact that Nigeria is regarded as fantastically corrupt country. I have never been in government. We are just contemplating on the percentage of the people that instituted corruption in Nigeria. And we have between 0.5 to 1.4%. Now, we are paying the price of becoming or being or coming from a fantastically corrupt country when most of us in diaspora has never ever held any political office in Nigeria or contributed in the corruption. Two, we want to end the insurgents, not just in Nigeria, but in entire West Africa. And by extension, Africa as a whole, European Union, and in America, because the problem we are having today, in the next 20 years, if Nigeria continues to be a country, Nigeria will become the biggest threat to Europe. Nigeria will become the biggest threat to America. We have seen it happening. So we are saving the future by calling for disintegration of Nigeria. Because as I'm talking now, there is no other solution to end the security issues in the region, in the entire West Africa region. The only solution to these security issues we're having today is disintegration. When you disintegrate Nigeria, you disintegrate the interest of the people that are sponsoring the terrorists. When you disintegrate Nigeria, you disintegrate the terrorists themselves, because the only reason for them killing people in the northern Nigeria is because Nigeria is one. And in the southern Nigeria, there are predominantly Christians, Muslims, few Muslims, and then other religions. And then in the northern Nigeria, you have few Christians, you have majority of Muslims, and they are comfortable with Sharia law. They are comfortable with Islamic State. You know, when we are making reference to Islamic State and Sharia law, people think that there are differences. There is no difference between Sharia and Islamic State. Once you are practicing Sharia law, automatically you are under Islamic State, because you are under Islamic law. So as I'm speaking to you today, being the 1st of May 2020, the 12 northern states in Nigeria are under Sharia law. And Boko Haram is fighting for Sharia. When you disintegrate Nigeria, you disintegrate the future threat that is coming to Europe. How will Nigeria become a threat to Europe? How will Nigeria become a threat to America? I'm going to explain it very briefly. By the time the North succeeded in annihilating the Southerners, at least those that refuse to be annihilated will be converted to what, to believe what they want. It can take them 100 years. It doesn't matter. Look at Turkey, for example. If they succeed in conquering Nigeria, like they have been pushing, they will begin to sponsor terrorists to attack Europe. They will begin to sponsor terrorists to attack America. It is not just about us. No, this is a historic issue that people ought to understand. We are fighting for the future. And the only way to stop it is that Biafra have their own army, which can never be compromised by any religion. Oduduwa have their own army, which can never be compromised by religion. Of course, I don't want to begin to argue from the religious context, because some Yorubas are Muslims and some of them are not Muslims. But today, we know down inside our heart that an average Muslim Yorubas are not regarded as real Muslim by the Fulanis. They don't regard them. But of course, like I said, I don't want to delve into religious issue. But the fact is that Oduduwa soldier cannot be compromised. We have seen it now, what is happening in Amotekun and all that, because Yorubas have come to realize that Igbos or Biafrans were never their enemy. And I am an advocate of unification of the southern part of Nigeria. I am an advocate of the unification, and those who comes to say every Biafra must do their own, and why Oduduwa do their own? They are agents of Nigeria. They are agents of division. They can never be agents of peace, because the Fulani planted hatred amongst us. They planted the hatred, and that hatred is why we are sitting here today, to see how to address it. And the hatred will continue to consume Nigeria until Southerners come together to form a common interest. Like you have in the North, you have the Northern Governors Forum, even when the Middle Belt is not supposed to be North, but they have scandalously or fraudulently taking the middle belt, and they make decisions that affect the region. But to the south, they push us and ask the governors, go and form your own governors forum. We will be funding it. We will be sending you money, and you cannot come together. Any day they come together, they will fight against that governor. It happens to governor of Lagos State, the former governor of Lagos State. Go and check it. He started the unification of southern governors in 2017. It is part, or it was part of the problem he had with the APC. They don't want him to come back because he tried to unify the governors. Go and check it. So what am I saying? What I'm saying this evening is this. Nigeria needs to be disintegrated to save the future of our children, future of our generation, future of Europe, future of America. You remember the one called the suicide bomber called Abdul Muttalab. Abdul Muttalab is a Nigerian. He traveled all the way from Nigeria to bomb America. That is the kind of terrorism that Nigeria will be sponsoring if they end up taking Nigeria as a whole, which will happen if Nigeria is not disintegrated. Thank you. Let me stop here.
Thank you very much. I have to give you a standing ovation for what you've done. I want a lot of love for Simon online. Simon, you've been wonderful. You've not just been wonderful, you've been excellent in educating our people. We need this kind of education regularly. We need to educate people. We need to let our people know that Yoruba and Igbos are not enemies. They just want to put an enmity between us. I'm not fighting for Biafra and Yoruba amalgamation. That's not what I'm looking for. But the unity must continue. The love we have for one another must continue. How many Igbos do you find in the north? How many Igbos do you find in the south? You can see the kind of love that is there from there. I really appreciate you. I really thank you. And I really want to commend you for your effort. I've watched your front page. I follow you. Please, guy online, if you're not following Simon Ekpa at the moment, you need to follow him to get educated about our struggle. It's our struggle together. It's a collective struggle. We need to follow him. We need to follow him closely so that we can know exactly what is going on and what is going on. Simon, thank you very much.